Hello dear students, you all are welcome to this video session of Subject SS, where today we are going to discuss a new topic, that is natural gas. Now it is found with petroleum deposits and it's released when crude oil is brought to the surface. Natural gas is anything which we are getting under the surface of the earth where the petroleum is available, so above that level natural gas is available. It can be used as domestic and in industrial fuels. Now we can get to use the natural resources, natural gas, in the domestic purpose. The red colored cylinders which are there in our kitchens contains the natural gas, which is known as the LPG, which is used for the cooking purpose. The industrial use, of course, natural gas is used in the iron industry and many other metal industry it is used. Russia, Norway, UK and the Netherlands are the major producers of the natural gas. So these are the country students which are the major producers of the natural gas. In India, Jaisalmer, Krishna, Godavari Delta, Tripura and some areas of shore in Mumbai have natural gas resources. Very few countries in the world have sufficient natural gas reserves of their own. So India also has some of the areas like Jaisalmer, Krishna, Godavari Delta, Tripura and some areas have the natural gas deposits, but some areas do not hold these natural gas resources reserves. The sharp increase in our consumption of fossil fuels has led to their depletion of at an alarming rate. So we are using the fossil fuels at a very fast rate, and due to this we can face the problem in future, the problems which are related with that, the toxic pollutants released from burning these fuels are also a cause of concern. The toxic and the poisonous gases which are released from these materials by burning this are released and which can be considered to be poisonous for our body and other creatures. Unchecked burning of the fossil fuel is like an unchecked dripping tap which will eventually run dry. And unchecked burning, it means when we are not checking the burning of fossil fuels, will face the problem. The dripping tap, it means in our house when dripping tap, when we are not turning it off the dripping tap, we may face the problem that the water will dry away. So in the same way, this has led to the tapping of various non-conventional sources of energy, and that are clearer alternatives to fossil fuels, and that all are considered to be the cleaner alternatives to fossil fuels. Now hydropower is one such thing. Rainwater or river water stored in dams is made to fall from the heights. Hydropower is something, students, that I wanted to show you. Is something which is the energy which is used to generate electricity. Now this is the dam, students, and the water is allowed to flow from these generators. The gates are opened and there are the generators fixed, the turbines which can rotate in this direction like this, and from that when the energy is rotated, the energy is stored and that can be supplied by the way of the electric channels, by the way of the electric lines and the wires. So this is known as hydropower. The moving blades then turn the generator to produce electricity, and this is called hydroelectricity. The word hydro means known as the water, and for this the water discharged after the generation of electricity is used for irrigation, and for this purpose we can use the water for the irrigation purpose. 1/4 of the world's electricity is produced by hydropower. The 1/4 part of the energy of the total world's electricity consumption will comes from the hydropower. And for the students, the leading producers of hydropower in the world are Paraguay, Norway, Brazil and China. The leading producers in the world for this are Paraguay, Norway, Brazil and China. Some important hydropower stations in India are Bakra Nagal, Gandhi Sagar, Nagarjun Sagar and Damodar Valley projects. And for this, students, the another means of using the energy are the non-conventional. So non-conventional energy is something, students, the increasing use of fossil fuels is leading to the shortage. The increasing use of the fossil fuels leads to the shortage, and for this, students, it is estimated that if the present rate of consumption continues, the reserves of these fuel will exhaust it, and If the present rate of the consumption will go on, one day it will happen that we'll have to continue ourselves without these reserves. Moreover, their use also causes environmental pollution. And moreover to this, their use also causes the environmental pollution. Therefore, there is a need for using non-conventional sources such as the solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, which are renewable. And due to this reason, student, the use of the solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, which are renewable, we should adopt those measures, those solar energy, those wind energy, tidal energy, and which all are the renewable energy sources. We must use this kind of energies. So students, for today's session, thank you for watching and have a nice day.